Well, where's Huggy Bear?
Dignan, he's not there. Huggy Bear is not in every single episode.
Wait a second. Running to different payphones, what the hell is that all about?
That's what I'm trying to explain to
you. See, sometimes, Anthony, you can have a dream of an episode, and then you think that
it actually happened. It's a real episode. The killer's leading him across the city by calling different payphones.
Why?
It's part of his plan. I don't know why he does it.
What I'm saying, Anthony, is that it has the logic of a dream.
The point is, the killer always goes, "May I speak to Starsky?" even though he knows it's him.
What does Starsky say?
He says this is he.
This is he?
I think. See what I meant about the window?
That's your strength, Anthony, your little touches like that. See, I thought it was superficial at first because we already had the keys, but you're thinking one step ahead to
what happens if they change the locks on
us. We couldn't get in because our keys wouldn't work, but now we can always get in through that window.
See, that window can never be locked. It's impossible. I filed it down.
See, my brain can't really think like that. You have that real good sense of mechanical, technological detail that just...
Thank you.
Thanks. Thank you very much. She's really kind of hot, you know.
Uh-huh.
She's an attractive woman.
Serious? Anthony, we'll get 200 for the points alone. Easily $200. That's less than what they're appraised at.
But Dignan, do you really know that much about rare coins?
Yeah, I do know. I know about money. I know the value of money, Anthony. Plus, Jesus Christ, the fucking earrings are worth three times that. Anthony, hold on. Look out.
I told you not to take the earrings.
You got another ball. Anthony, I'm playing your game.
The list, you remember the list? It's things Dignan wasn't supposed to touch.
I don't think that the earrings were on the list.
The earrings were number three on the list. Everything in the mahogany box was on the list.
Well, Anthony, it wasn't worth the risk to even go in there if we'd gone by the list, because every valuable
item... That does not make any difference. I bought the earrings for my mother on her birthday. I picked them out myself.
Well, I can't be sorting through all that shit in the middle of a burglary. There's just not time for it.
Dignan, if I'd known you were going to ignore everything I'd said, we'd have never gone in there. I can promise you, you'd never have gone in there.
Just be practical, Anthony. When we do a job, we do it to the best of our abilities, right? We're trying to do it like professionals, because that's what we are. We're professionals.
What the fuck does that have to do with it? I told you not to take my mother's fucking earrings.
I'm lookout.
Dignan, it's got no more.
I don't think so. Just reach on
me. Yeah, that sets it off.
Anthony, do it real quick, and I'll meet you down there.
Had an alarm.
Yeah, I heard that.
$5, $7, $8.
Holy shit, what'd I tell you?
$8.
That's not bad.
Cinnamon or what?
Yeah, any kind of herb that grows.
What do they have to do with it, though? I don't understand the connection.
Pot is an herb. It's like any other kind of gardening.
How much could you grow realistically?
Much as I want. That's crop I've got right now. When it comes up, I'll have $6,000 worth of weed.
$6,000? Are you serious?
Yeah. You should see it. I've got an entire crop in my backyard.
At the house? How do you protect all that?
Nobody comes over there. It's private property. Besides, I have Hector.
Hector? Man, Hector wouldn't do anything.
Hector's not going to do anything, Bob.
Hector has a loud bark. It's a loud bark that really counts.
If it's that easy, how come everybody isn't doing it?
Good question. Don't you guys tell anybody about my plants.
You're paranoid, Bob. Come on.
You just don't tell anybody.
Could you grow cinnamon?
I don't know, sure, I guess.
You could have your own cinnamon toast if you grow that.
A weapon is anything you hold in your hand. It can be a knife, it can be a Coke bottle, it can be a pencil, a ballpoint pen. You can stick them right here and rupture the esophagus. You give them a ballpoint tracheotomy.
And what kind do you recommend? I mean, if we want a gun, just to intimidate someone.
No, you don't want to do that. That's suicidal. You don't intimidate people with guns, you shoot people with guns.
Most important thing you can have is the escape route. Okay, one more thing we need to discuss. Gotta come up with a getaway strategy, just in case somebody's tailing us or even chasing us, as the case may be.
You think we're gonna be chased?
That's a good question. No, I don't think we're gonna be chased. I'm just being hypocritical now. But there's an advantage to having a plan. We know where we're going. You say the person behind us doesn't know where he's being taken. We know all the stops, all the lights, all the turns. We're always one step ahead. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Okay, Bob, hang on a second, because this is important. Responsibility. Anthony and I are responsible for the internal situation. That's money and people. You're responsible for the external situation. The car, getaway, the streets.
That's my responsibility.
All right, that's your domain. Okay. One thing we need to discuss is timing, because that's crucial.
This thing
Bob, goddamn, what the fuck is your problem?
I'm paying attention, Dignan.
Bob, you're not paying attention if you're fucking around with the gun. Now quit fucking around with the gun and start paying attention, because you're fucking...
Anthony, give me the fucking
Dignan,
gun.
Dignan, relax. It's not your gun, okay?
Fuck you too, Bob. Assholes, bastards, cowards. I invent everything. I come up with the whole fucking plan.
You're out of my house, asshole.
Yeah, yeah, and who comes up with the plan? Thanks. Thanks, Bob. Thanks, Anthony. Dicks. Fuckers.
Say to the guy, can
can I get in there? I think I left my wallet. And he says, I'm sorry, sir, we're closed for the evening. And I said, just for a second, do you have a lost and found?
Yeah, and that was
something that I would check.
When Anthony goes, do you have a lost and found? Then the guy lets in, he opens the door, and then all of a sudden I'm in there. He's like, what's going on?
I don't know. He surprised me.
And then I've got like the gun on him. We're like pushing them back. Then we didn't have the right size bag.
Yeah. And then starts going, We're gonna need a bigger bag.
We've got to have a bigger bag.
Was he like screaming?
No, I wasn't screaming. I was calm.
What about what the guy said to you, though?
Oh, man. Bob, the manager goes to me. The manager goes, I'm going to remember you.
Are you serious?
Yeah, he said that to him.
Just like that, I swear to God, in a real serious voice.
Like he'd find Dignan one day.
Yeah.
If it took him the rest of his life, he'd search out Dignan.
Like he'd hunt me down and kill me.
What did he say to you?
I don't think he really even got a good look at me. Dignan scared him so bad, they didn't even look at me anymore.
I can't believe how easy that was.
See ya.
Bob.
See you later, Bob.
Bob.
Man. That was great driving. Seriously, that was really good driving.
Okay.
$183 is a pretty good haul, Bob.
Good driving.
These shoes will kill yours.
You want to make a bet?
Sure, I'll bet you.
Well, let's bet then. How much you want to bet?
I don't really care.
Forget it then, Anthony, because I'm not racing unless we're betting.
Okay, how much do you want to bet?
I'll bet you anything.
Right now?
Fuck yeah, right now.
Okay. Let's go to the back of the mailbox.
Let's make it the Lincoln.
Okay, the back of the Lincoln. On your mark?
No, I'm going to say it.
On your marks. Get to go. Thank you.